Welcome to the Netherlands, where the straw waffles are always fresh and the tulips are always in bloom. As an expat myself, I know how overwhelming it is moving to a new country, but don't worry, I've got you covered. Hello, my name is Tega, and I've been living in the Netherlands for over 2 years. And in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you 10 necessary things you need to do to help you get settled in the Netherlands. So, let's go. You want to be reachable when you come into the country. I personally got mine at the airport when I landed, so just get a SIM card. It's so easy to register, so you can be reachable in the Netherlands. Now, why is it possible to get a house before you come into the Netherlands? I think it is quite tricky because you might get scammed on many social media platforms. Apart from getting scammed, it is also good to just be present to see the house and know if it's something that really fits your needs. So I'd advise you coming to the country, maybe get a cheap hostel or an Airbnb to stay, then begin your house search. It is also important to know that the rental market is highly competitive. When you find a house, it is necessary to react as soon as possible. I'll be dropping the link of two popular websites where you can check for houses and hopefully you find something you like as soon as possible. Required to register with your local municipality, and for this you need to book an appointment and go in person. You'll be needing the following documents: a legalized birth certificate and your rental contract. Also good to inform you that if you cannot find an apartment by the time you have to register, then you can also ask for a permission form. What is a permission form? A permission form is a form that you can get from someone who already has an apartment. All they have to do is to fill this form and give you like a proof of identity, and you can register at their apartment. The next document you'll be needing is your marriage certificate. That is if you're married, and also have it in mind that it has to be legalized. The next document you're going to be needing is a valid passport or ID card. Now, before I move to the next point, if a document is not written in Dutch, German, English or French, then you have to translate it. Remember, you'll receive your citizen service number, also known as BSN, once you're done registering. And with your BSN, you can open a bank account, you can communicate with the government over tax issues and every other thing you need to do. You will need to open a Dutch bank account, and for this you would need your BSN, a valid passport and a proof of address. Now, if you're living or working in the Netherlands, you're obligated to take out a basic health insurance, and you must do this within 4 months of being in the country. If you do not take it in the first 4 months, you're gonna get a letter reminding you to do so. And if you say, oh, I don't need that, and you still do not take it, you're gonna get a fine and also be reminded to take it. And if you say, I have coconut head, I don't want to do it, and still wait, then you're gonna get another fine. And after that fine, the Dutch central office will take out a 12 month period insurance for you, and then you'll be obligated to pay them every month the premium. Talk about the loan you didn't know you needed, right? To take out the basic health insurance, you need your BSN, a valid passport, and you also need your bank account details. I'll be dropping the link in the description box where you can choose and compare and see what package fits your needs. It is very important to register with your general practitioner as soon as you settle your health insurance, because if you fall ill and not have one already, it might be difficult to find a practice that is available to accept you. I'll be dropping a link where you can find a lot of GPs around you, and hopefully you get to pick one that you would like. If you have indicated while filling your application form to come to the Netherlands that you're going to go for the tuberculosis test, then book an appointment with the GGD when you come into the country. It's important to go for this test within 3 months of arrival, because there's a clause that says if you fail to go within 3 months, you might get your permit revoked, and you don't want that, right? Like the name sounds, it is your digital ID, and you can use it to apply for taxis, go on many government websites. And for this, you need your BSN. See how your BSN keeps popping in everything, right? I'll be dropping a link where you can just request for your DGD. You can get a lovely chip card mostly at the train station, and you can use this card for the trams, the metros, and even for the buses and the train. You can decide to get a single card or anonymous card or the personal card that comes with the subscription. Netherlands is known for its cycling culture, and honestly, I think the transportation system is a bit expensive. So unless you have to go for long trips, get a bike. And if you are like me that couldn't cycle when I came to the country, it's not so difficult. Trust me, in no time, you will be cycling like I do right now. Also remember to read about the cycling rules here in the Netherlands, because it might be different from wherever you're coming from. Explore the country. The Netherlands has so much to offer. There are lots of beaches, a lot of cities. Take your time, explore the country, and learn a bit of Dutch. Doesn't hurt to learn a bit of Dutch. It will help you to integrate more in the societies. On a final note, it might be so overwhelming trying to settle in a new country, so give yourself time to transition. Thank you guys for watching, and if you have other tips that we need to know, you can drop them in the comment section. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and click on the notification button, and see you in my next video. Bye.